Alright, so you've picked up one of our catapult kits. These come in a pair, so you can have a little ping pong battle with your kid or nephew, whatever you want to do. We'll open the kit up and go over all the parts inside of it. Alright, so we have two base plates with the throwing arms attached, and then two sets of your uprights. You've got two latex tubes, two quarter inch rods, and some zip ties. You have to provide your own ping pong balls. Other than our kit and the parts of it, really all you're gonna need to put this together is a grinder with a cutoff wheel. This is an 045 disc. Make sure you have a guard on those guys. And a flap disc or other abrasive tool is going to be helpful. You should have a guard on that too. Do not use your cutoff wheel as a grinding tool. It's not safe. A Sharpie will be helpful, but not required. You need safety gear for when you're using your grinder. Pair of pliers, again, helpful but not required. And then gloves, welding helmet, and your welder. In this case, we're gonna be using a MIG welder. Well, I'm using the MIG welder, and it is definitely what I would suggest. You could put this together with flux core, TIG welding, or stick welding. TIG, you're gonna need to clean all the metal up before you weld it, grind off any of the mill scale, and stick, you're gonna have to be real delicate because there are some small parts here, easy to melt through. Start off with your base plates. The throwing arm is these three vertical strips. The base plate's the big rectangle. You can just fatigue these apart, bend them back and forth a couple times. You also have your cross bars. Those come off. There we go. Now, if you don't want to fatigue them apart or you have these small pieces, you're just going to take a cutting wheel and get those guys apart. Or you can fatigue them again, whatever you want to do. When it comes to your uprights, this rectangle in here is what needs to go. Lots of ways to do that. An easy way is twist it. Doing that with your kids, I would suggest maybe you do that for them. Now your pieces where they were broken apart are going to have little nubs left over. You can clean those up. A flap disc is going to be an easy way to do that, or a belt grinder is easy to show you. So the kits are 14 gauge steel. We want to weld just a little bit under your normal settings for 14 gauge, or at least start there, because we've got some larger gaps, wanted it to be easier for kids to put together, and we need to fill those in. So I've got my machine set up for right about the settings for 16 gauge. So your base plate here facing up, if you look at the bottom side, you'll see a little bit of dross from the cuts. That's how you can identify the bottom. Or you can look down the piece and there's a slight bevel. This is the top, this is the bottom, and the bevel is a hill. We'll put that down. The uprights can only go on in one way. You can't turn them around because the holes don't line up. So we'll set that guy into place and we'll start with just one tack, a small weld to hold it in place. Really helpful to turn the welding gas on. And we'll do the other side. Now we have our spreader bars that are gonna go between the uprights. Because they're just tacked into place, you can adjust everything right here. We'll get that guy all lined up. And then we're gonna shoot a small tack in on these two corners. So with everything just tacked together, let's line it up. We can flex this. Get everything to sit nice and vertical. Went too far that time. There we go. That's the beauty of a tack. If you do break your tack, just put another one on. You're not going to hurt anything. Now we'll tack the remainder of the joints that hold everything into place. The base is tacked together. You can weld the thing fully out, but it's assembled as much as it needs to be to move on to putting the arm together. Okay, for our arm, the wing pieces are going to fold down. It'll be difficult to do with the welding glove on. That makes like a U shape right there. And then the little throwing arm, these come up to 45 degrees. If you're having trouble bending them, a wrench or a pair of pliers will make your life a little easier. These have some adjustment in them. You don't even really have to weld these out, but we're going to, just to get more welding practice. Okay, and again, we're just gonna tack everything together to hold it into place. If you want to, you can weld out as much of it as you want to. Then the arms, we'll just put a couple tacks down the length. All right, so we now have the majority of the work done. The arm, gonna sit in here, and that's your throwing action there. So before we take our axle piece, which is going to go through here, through the two holes in the arm, and just set into these two notches, and that gets welded in. What we wanna do is grab a Sharpie and mark where that's gonna be. I'm gonna leave about a quarter inch hanging out both sides. We know this is the axle side. So we have all of this to make the supports to hold the latex tubing up at the top. You get to have some fun with it here. I'm gonna set mine out kind of like antenna at a 45 degree angle. And then I'm gonna measure off, just by eye, about an inch of that and make a cut. Then we're gonna repeat on the other side. There we go, we'll cut that side off too. And then if you have any remaining length for your axle, you can cut that off here or do so later. I'm gonna cut it off here. I'll set the axle to the side. Now these guys are gonna be sharp on the tops, so we're gonna clean them up with a flap disc. Just gonna very gently go around the edge. You could do this with a file too. There we go. Now with that done, we'll take our axle, slide it through the arms, and set that into place on the frame. Now this axle just gets tacked in. I wouldn't do much more on a tack. It's all you need. And just to be clear, I like for this guy to be loose on the axle. It allows you to kind of kick that over to the side and angle your shots a little bit as you're having fun. But if you don't want to do that, you can take a zip tie and zip tie it onto the axle to pin that guy into place, or before sliding the axle in, or just cut it off. That's why I said just put a tack on. You can slide a washer on either side of here and tack those on, which will pin this guy in place. I think it's overkill. I think the angle's better, but your call. It's your kit. This dude is pretty much done. We're gonna let it cool down, and then we'll get to assembling the latex tube for the actual shooting mechanism. Okay, so with your kit, you're gonna get two latex tubes. They are definitely longer than they need to be, but we'd rather you get to trim them down than be lacking. Slide your latex tube over one end of the little antler-looking spikes we put together, and zip tie it into place. Get that zip tie real nice and tight. There you go. And slip that off. Now, take your arm, bend it around, and we'll start off with the latex tube just slipped over the other side at the full length we send you, and hold on to that. You'll pull this guy back, and you can see how hard it shoots. It's decently hard. Let's see how far it'll send a ping pong ball. So the full length latex tube, uncut, it's gonna shoot a ping pong ball like 8 to 10 feet. Okay, so if that range is good for you, for your kids, that's fine. Just go ahead and put a zip tie on the other side just like we did here. I'd like to make this one shoot a little bit further. So I'm gonna cut off, about 2 inches of the latex tube. You get to choose what you want to do, and if you mess it up and need to get more tube, it's just standard quarter inch latex tube that you can pick up at any home store. The latex tube goes into the little notch in the arm just to help keep it centered, keep it from sliding, and it gives you the ideal shooting angle. So let's try this one out now. Yeah, with how hard this is pulling back, you kind of need to hold on to the base of the catapult. There you go, about twice as far. So once you're happy with your tube length, put your other zip tie on over here. And if you want to, if you're gonna play with this a bunch, you can stiffen up these joints around your throwing arm with some more weld. You know, if you're real rough on it, they will wear out. You can also finish welding everything out, paint it, do whatever you want to. Another one you can do as you're experimenting is you can cut your tube holders here and change the angle on them if you want to get a little science-y with your kids and teach them something about geometry and spring constants and all of that. Depending on their age, might be above their pay grade though. Have fun. So from the crew over at WeldItYourselfKids.com, I appreciate you guys making an order. Hopefully this is a fun little one you can do with some of the youngsters in your life. And you get two, so go ahead and have a battle.